freshman from Frederick, Maryland. Deep to take the kick. To the far side, Addison will signal for the fair catch. And the Panthers will start first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Tip Davis starts as the running back. He's a sophomore from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, who is their leading rusher. And he'll get the call here, cutting back to the left side. Davis bouncing away and has 10, 15, and nearly 20 yards on first down.
Active in the middle, playing a lot more like Scott Satterfield's linebackers played at App State. Downhill attacking.
Little tempo used by the Panthers here on third down, and a quick throw to the near side. This is the freshman Addison cutting into Louisville territory and tripped up shy of the 25-yard line is Jordan Addison. Down, and he ran right through that.
Yeah, Pat Narduzzi said that he expected this or more from the freshman.
So Pickett, two of his first four. Third and 10. Tried to flip it out in the flat. That was intended for Vincent Davis, and it's incomplete. And on their opening drive, now Pat Narduzzi. Christodoulou holds, and the kick is away by Alex Kessman, and it is good. His first conversion of the year in four tries, and Pittsburgh's on the board first here at Heinz Field. And the fumble of the football, but I think right back on it with Javian Hawkins. Here's third and long for Cunningham and the Cardinals, and under duress, Patrick Jones will sack him.
Well, what with man coverage on the back end, but Malik Cunningham didn't have any time. Look at Patrick Jones just shoving Adonis Boone into the backfield, into the lap of Malik Cunningham.
Technically, Roddy, it's three and out for the Pittsburgh defense. Throw away the two penalties. Here's the punt. Travelstead, and this is Addison. Working back here to the near side and into plus territory, out of bounds near the 25 of the Cardinals.
Big play west for Louisville's defense. I mean, think of the boost that they'll get with two stops here.
Here's Pickett trying to find Addison again on the inside, and that got blown up, and that was C.J. Avery. And the kick by Kessman is good. Here's Cunningham to work. This is Hawkins and hit head on. And that was Kalijah Kansi, who they could not quit talking about this week.
Narduzzi said that Kalijah Kansi has Jalen Twyman-like quickness.
Cunningham on a straight drop. Weaver almost got there. The throw is too high. Intended for Justin Marshall. Or beg your pardon, that is Logan Lupo. I apologize. And Lupo hangs it high. And a fair catch call for at the 40-yard line. That's Addison moving to a slot on the right. The first down given. This is A.J. Davis stepping through one tackle, make it two. And 17 yards and a first down to the Louisville 43-yard line.
Success is just going the other way. It's just an outside zone play. And Davis does a great job of keeping his balance.
Knew that the offense is what shines for Louisville as we watch Kenny Pickett drop back and see if these defenders can make a play again or if he's going to be able to wiggle out of it, Wes.
All right, here's Pickett fighting back. Lots of time on his feet and finally gets tracked down by Dorian Etheridge. Down and nine here for the Panthers. Pickett zips it down the field. And that is the first catch of the year for Taysir Mack, who returns to the lineup for Pat Narduzzi after missing the first couple of weeks, Roddy.
Down at the bottom of the screen on the inside in that bunch formation.
Yeah, with Addison on the perimeter, and Pickett looked that way to start. Now dances away again from pressure. Throws back across. The catch is made. A.J. Davis took a big lick, held on for the first down, and Davis is down. You get the different jerseys, Roddy. You know, stuff can happen.
Absolutely.
Here's second down, and this is Abanikanda. Moving in. Close to another first down for Pittsburgh on second down.
Guy that was the Gatorade Player of the Year as a senior in the state of New York. Shows you why the coaches are excited.
Yeah, just his sixth carry of the season, and he's right back at it here on first and goal. And Addison to the top on the right side here. Along with the veteran Trey Tipton. Here's Pickett. Pass and catch for the touchdown, and it's Jordan Addison in the end zone again, Roddy. Second touchdown catch of the season for Addison, the freshman from Maryland.
Addison in the middle. He's going to run up, run a little stop right there, and then come back to the inside.
Yards and a touchdown. As you see him visit with his offensive coordinator, Mark Whipple. And here is Jamian Hawkins breaking free and trying to win the race to the end zone. And will, 75 yards. And Louisville lights the fuse just like that, Roddy.
There, and it's a foot race. The corners are playing man-to-man, so they get a late start. You see him able to avoid Damar Hamlin, and then it's all about speed, and Javian Hawkins has plenty of it.
Pittsburgh 4-6 on third down today. Abanacanda again fights back upfield. He'll have the first down, gets toward the Panthers' 40-yard line. Pickett to work from the pocket. Flips it on the perimeter. Abanacanda tried to make a man miss and couldn't. Wrapped up by Robert Hicks. And they have now switched it, and we get a little wildcat formation here. And the snap juggled by Vincent Davis, and it goes backwards a lot. 14 yards, I believe. We'll see how they step it off. They measured at 12, a loss of 12 back to the 38. Field first and 10 when things went bad for Pat Narduzzi's team.
Yeah, I couldn't tell if that was.
Cristodulo, ninth in the league in net at 36 yards. That is Rajay Burns, rather, not Javian Hawkins, I believe. I'm going to hand it to Davis, and boy, the Cardinals feeling pretty good about themselves. Third and about a river to cross for Pittsburgh. Pickett checks it underneath. And here is Davis across midfield to where the original spot of the ball was to begin the quarter to the 48. Hall's come in. Cunningham to the pistol. It's Atwell in motion. And Cunningham wants to throw and was looking here near side for Fitzpatrick. And now a flag has come in. Is that against Pinnock? And 10 at the 27. Hall, no sir. Wow. Hall stays in the ball game. And Cunningham wants to throw. Near side and open. And this is Marshawn Ford, the tight end. Fights upfield for the first down in front of the Pittsburgh bench where he got knocked down by Pinnock near the 44-yard line.
Certainly is. He's lined up. You see him coming out of the backfield. And the big thing is he kind of does everything. He's a fantastic blocker. Doesn't often.
Third and long, and Cunningham to throw. Back across the middle, Atwell to catch in traffic and hit by Ford at the Pittsburgh 43-yard line.
But yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Uh-oh, a little mix-up in the backfield. They ran into one another. Now onto the flat on the right side. Here's Braden Smith with outstanding speed down the far side and knocked out of bounds around the 17, 16-yard line. Loss of a half yard, and Cunningham to throw here on second down. Back up into the pocket, and the hit made. Servassier Dennis. Cunningham tries to escape and cannot. It looked like Keyshawn Camp was the guy wreaking havoc against the right side of Louisville's offensive line here.
Seeing that you have these two great defensive ends who push the pressure, and then you have the guys up the middle that keep the integrity of the pocket.
The kick is good.
They ran it 46% of the time a year ago.
3-point lead for the Panthers. Feels like a big drive for Pittsburgh. Ball deflected in the air and almost intercepted. Jared Goldwire, the big senior, after it looked like Abdullah got a hand on it. Yasir Abdullah. And then
they're going to say Louisville got it. Looks
and
like.
Now they're going
on the field is a fumble recovered by the defense. First down.
Oh, my.
Kenny Pickett was trying to go to Taysier Mack up the seam. Yeah, I think that's going to be overturned and be declared an incomplete pass. His arm clearly going forward. He's trying to go to Taysier Mack right up the middle.
Right.
The question is the ball knocked out before his arm starts coming forward? I'm not sure that we've seen an angle that's going to tell us definitively. Maybe this one will tell us. Man, that's close. I would say that it looks like his arm is going forward.
Pistol set in the three receivers. Cunningham wants the throw and open in the end zone for the touchdown is Tutu Atwell, and the Cards are in front. What a response by Scott Satterfield's team here with 6:51 to go in the first half.
On the back end, the question is by who? It looks like they're in man-to-man coverage, and Damar Hamlin just looks in the backfield and lets Tutu Atwell run right by him. Defense was dominating Syracuse offense. Now you have faced, now you are facing a foe that is your equal. How do you respond?
Here's Pickett. Doesn't have a seam to throw. Going to take off and run with it, and he's got 14, almost 15 yards on first down. Pretty big third down play with under six to go, and Louisville in front after the Cunningham to Atwell touchdown. And Pickett to throw, and the house is coming for Brian Brown. Pickett got to cut it loose somewhere. Does, and it is intercepted. No, caught. That ball caught in traffic. What a great catch by Jordan Addison here, Roddy. I thought that ball was going to be picked by Russ Yeast.
It's incredible as we get another look at the catch. Kenny Pickett does a good job of keeping the play alive. See what happens with Yeast. It hits off of him into the lap of Jordan Addison.
Well, the bench thinks he's picked it.
Exactly. And he's got his hands on it. Oh, Addison just snatches it away or
what? Oh, and he got two down. It's a Sunday catch. Come on now. Cost him the first down play there. So now it is third down and seven. And here's Pickett. A little delay shovel, and that was Turner, but going nowhere because that got handled very well by Rajay Burns. What Pickett has planned. Cards bring a couple extra guys. There's the throw. Mack to catch a first down. Taysir Mack to the 25. He spun off, stayed on his feet. He's going to go to the end zone, and it's going to be called a touchdown. Yes, it has, Roddy. Yes, it has.
Let's see the catch there. Let's see if we can get a look. I don't see his knee hitting the ground. I think Taysir Mack was completely right and continuing. And
here's another look. Watch the knees.
Left one certainly does not hit. The right one is the one that's in question.
It hits the top of the shoe. Does not hit the ground.
Does not hit the ground. So, again, from the looks that we have seen so far, it is going to stand. It's a nice job of Taysir Mack playing.
Cunningham dropping back. Weaver had it for a moment and runs him right into a teammate. And that's Bill Campbell, the fifth-year senior.
Same thing that you do to get ready for the game, Wes.
Well, more Sinatra, but thanks. You're there. You're close. Here's the catch. Falling to the ground is Davis. That'll be a first down at the 36-yard line.
On the risk of an incomplete pass.
Yep. It's going to be a throw. And it's batted at the line of scrimmage, incomplete, trying to go to Taysir Mack. Has only one return on the year for 7 yards, and that was a couple of weeks ago in the opener against Western Kentucky. Krista Dulo, little rugby kick toward Burns, and he will catch it going out of bounds at the Louisville 25-yard line. Second and 10. Cunningham wants to throw. Here comes some trouble, and Malik Cunningham will not get away from Patrick Jones, Keyshawn Camp, and Rashad Weaver. It's a law firm on the Pitt defensive front.
It's a Louisville team that really survived Pitt getting after him in the first quarter to bring it close.
Ooh, trying to get Hawkins started. He spun away from Jones and got hit by Camp and then a couple of others, Kelsey. Well, that time Cam Bright finished off the work of Patrick Jones, and now second and long. And now Cunningham trying to go up over the top, and it's intercepted. And it's picked off, and coming back is Marquez Williams with the interception, and Pittsburgh's going to end up with plus field possession after the turnover by the Cards. Justin Marshall, the intended receiver.
Get an interception, but watch this. Marshall has a step. Pinnock just plays it really well. Kind of does a little veteran move, shoving him just past the ball, and then picks it off. It's not pass interference. The receiver's got to be strong and go up. It's a nice job by Marquez Williams. It just shows you how important he thinks it is for a good start to the second half.
Now bringing pressure on third down. Pickett rips it from the pocket, and that's caught. That's the tight end, Moraga, and that's a first down to the 21.
This Pitt team now has a chance to put points on the board and really make Louisville chase.
Pickett escapes up the field. Kenny Pickett gets a first down inside the 20 and then gears down about the 18-yard line.
I mean, Louisville's been able to do that at times, but they haven't been able to bring Kenny Pickett down because of the lanes that have opened up in the middle.
Pat Narduzzi about just Carter Warren reshaping his body, just being a totally different player than he was a year ago at that left tackle spot. Pickett and sacked and fumbled, but recovered on the play by Davis. Boy, he got lit up by Abdullah.
We brought the corner, and you mentioned Van Lynn coming out. He slides out to the corner. Nobody picks up Abdullah.
Cards bringing four. They'll slip it here to Davis on the near side. Tried to get something in the screen game and cannot because Monty Montgomery lowered the boom. On the near hash mark. And the kick is good. So three field goals for Alex Kessman today. The interception only cost him a field goal. And boy, Javian Hawkins, outside of the 75-yard run, has had a hard time getting started today, Roddy. And a play fake from Cunningham. Cuts it loose, Fitzpatrick the catch. And a first down as he stiff arms Williams to get to the sideline at the 37.
We have not been able to get that going at all today.
Cunningham looking for the quick throw and the sixth sack of the day. And that is Patrick Jones again.
Anything going early in the run game. This was a Louisville offense that ran the ball more than everybody in the conference other than Boston College a year ago.
Right.
That's been the struggle here today.
Yep. Third down and 11. Cunningham again on a drop. Rashad Weaver is going to drop him. So sacks on back-to-back plays for the Panthers.
Good call by the referees, and honestly, it should be reviewed.
Yep.
But ultimately, a good call.
Third down, nonetheless, here for the Panthers after the play. Pickett steps up, zips it across the middle of the field in a big collision with Jared Wayne, and now a flag has been thrown there. Still a six-point game here at Heinz Field. And Kirk Christodoulou gets a leg into this. Burns back at the 19. Looking for some room, and we'll get to the 25, and we're going to play on from Heinz Field. Cam hitting 64% of his passes coming in, is 50% until the throw here for Hawkins, who slips down ahead of the chain at the 34. And they're still going to fake it. Around the edge they go. First down and more for Louisville. Down the far sideline, Tabarius Peterson, the defensive lineman.
Scott Satterfield outthought the Pittsburgh coaching staff there. Good job by Scott Satterfield of being a step ahead.
Fake punt pays off with Peterson. And the drive is alive for the Cardinals, who are down six. Well, one of seven today on third down, Roddy. They came in at 43%. Here's Cunningham on the keeper. Steps out of one and will be cut down short at the 31. It's a yard to the first down stake.
Has 12 tackles for loss so far in this game. They have been in the backfield all day long.
There's Cunningham, wants to throw, hit as he does. They're looking for Atwell. Incomplete, and a flag will be thrown against A.J. Woods. On Hall in the backfield now. Cunningham wants to throw, pressure coming, hit as he does. Atwell caught it. Is he in? Juggled it going through the end zone, ended up on the tarp. Kick is away and right down the seam.
Did the team all last year, Wes.
Throwing first down to Taysir Mack.
To get away for a little while, and it meant so much to the players as well.
It's a great story, and Randy Bates, a remarkable coaching journey. And here is Davis spinning away toward midfield before the Cardinals can finally draw him down, Roddy.
And still, this Louisville defense has kept him in the game. Yeah. Only giving up 23.
Turner in motion, Pickett pushing the pocket, and Turner the catch and a first down. Knocked out of bounds and done so over there by Avery.
And it feels like Pitt's trying to shorten the game, going to this I formation, running the football.
Yep. Here is Davis banging away, looking for an extra block. Got it inside the 25 to the 24, and a nice run there. Drive the Pittsburgh offense here.
Pat Narduzzi has said a number of times he's looking for one of these running backs to just take it.
Trying to find it. Davis and cannot get started. Big time play in the back that time. 34 employed by Brian Brown, and he's played well today.
Yeah, they don't cut off the backside. They're able to convert here on fourth down. They're going to, excuse me, on third down. They're going to continue that.
Yep. Snap to Pickett. Back across the middle and intercepted off the deflection. The ball picked off, and that's C.J. Avery working back up the far sideline and across the 40 to the 45.
Second of the day. Let's see where this ball is. It's a little high and outside, and the deflection makes it an easy pick for C.J. Avery. Not quite as on target as I originally thought, but Louisville able to dodge a bullet.
You know, these coaches definitely have energy, and the players were involved there too.
Cunningham trying for the shot and the interception. And it's Hamlin who's come up with the pick. And now DeMar Hamlin will circle around the field.
Did not expect Hamlin to fall off and recover under this route, but an easy pick. We've been put in some bad situations over the course of this game and forced Pitt to kick field goals, and it really kept this game close.
Here's Pickett firing to the far side. What a catch by Addison. A shoe-top catch around the 47-yard line. He's measured out at the 50, and that'll extend the drive.
And if you're able to put points on the board, that obviously makes it tougher, but so does the fact that your defense has played well, and Louisville is just not going to have a ton of shots. As you see, Pitt moves the chains with another first down.
Yep, that'll take him up near 150 yards of rushing. Manicanda stays in the backfield. Pickett wants to throw here. Works to the right, and that ball got knocked out of bounds, and then it went out near the 40 or the 39, which would not be a significant loss. Let's see where Stuart Mullen spots it here. Under 7 minutes we go. Cardinals bring four, quick throw, crossing route. Addison trying to turn it upfield, and he got knocked down at the 32-yard line. Snap to Pickett. Kenny gonna look, now pump, now throw, and dropped. It hit Turner right at the 22-yard line, and DJ Turner couldn't squeeze it. Third down and seven. Under five to go. Cunningham put it up for grabs, and it was caught, but shy of the first down.
Going to go into their four. They've been in their four-minute offense the entire fourth quarter, it seems like.
Pittsburgh's leaving the defense on the field. That got punted away toward Addison, who will make the fair catch. We'll take a timeout. Here is Pickett and the Panthers to work, and they give it to Turner, a little sweep around the edge for 5, 10, 15, knocked out of bounds up around the 40, 41-yard line. And first and 10 for the Panthers, who are right in the run game now. And now Davis is taken down behind the line, and another play for Abdullah. The freshman Vincent Davis with him, or sophomore Vincent Davis with him in the backfield. And they are going to throw here out of the timeout on third down. Going to take the shot for Addison over the top and incomplete. Isaiah Hayes in coverage for the Cards. Rajay Burns will wait. Kirk Christodoulou the punt. And it's a good one. Hangs it high to the near side. Fair catch made inside the 20 around the 17. 2:27 to go. Number 21 Panthers lead number 24 Louisville by three. Malik Cunningham cut through, runs through one tackle, and picks up the first down at the 28-yard line. First down and 10, clock at 2 minutes. Atwell in motion. Remember, he was shaken up earlier, too. Trying to set the screen and incomplete. Atwell was coming back for it.
Getting under the block and disrupting this, it is so hard for these corners.
Second down, 10. Quick throw. Catch made. Fitzpatrick got knocked out. No, Atwell.
To be able to find a receiver downfield.
1:46 to go. They went to the sideline the last two attempts here. Here's Cunningham escaping the pocket. Weaver gives chase. He heads to the far side, keeps his feet, but slides down. Out of the pit timeout. Cunningham wants to throw. Pressure coming. He will put it up for grabs, and it's intercepted. Pinnock gets the pick. And a guy who did a really good job last week on Taj Harris of Syracuse, Roddy. And Pat Narduzzi made a point to say, look, Jason Pinnock did a really good job on Taj Harris.
Sure did.
They said busted play was a function of the execution on the coverage.
Defense was too overwhelming. Kenny Pickett and this offense did just enough. And in the second half, remember, especially in the fourth quarter, Pitt went to basically a four-corner offense.
Yep.
They went into their four-minute offense, running the football from under center and shortening the ball game.